Here's the latest stories making the headline amongst the Filipino community.
Breach of the Capitol to the upper level.
This shocking incident on January 6th last year prompted a House of Representatives Select Committee to hold a series of hearings to investigate what happened on that violent day that left one dead and hundreds injured, including 138 police officers. This committee has shown revealing testimony and new evidence and is holding former President Donald Trump responsible for the attack on the Capitol, raising crimes they believe Trump may have committed. Most Republicans polled say the incident was just a political protest and an unfortunate event.
Exercising what you believe with should have been a little bit more on the prudent side, not like what they did. And it was also went too far on what they were believing with it. It's just because, you know, it's a very poor judgment for everybody else.
As of March 2022, 778 have already been criminally charged in relation to the attack on the Capitol, with over 100 pleading guilty. One of them is Philam Keen Brian Lazo of Norfolk, Virginia. Lazo pleaded guilty in March to demonstrating and parading in the Capitol building. Lazo, who faces up to 6 months in prison, is scheduled to be sentenced on August 18. Still in Washington, D.C., the U.S. State Department recently released its annual human trafficking report, revealing that 21 countries have improved their efforts in combating the issue, but 18 have been downgraded.
The scale of this problem is vast. There are nearly 25 million people currently victims of trafficking. 25 million people.
The report shows the Philippines has maintained its Tier 1 status, the highest ranking that indicates the government has made efforts to address the problem. Blinken highlights the country's efforts to improve data collection as one tool to help tackle human trafficking.
In the Philippines, to cite one example, the government launched a technology platform so that multiple agencies can work together to manage cases of victims as well as prosecute their traffickers.
And finally, let's go to Southern California, where the community got to preview the highly anticipated film Easter Sunday, starring acclaimed Philam comedian Joe Coy. Some 600 people packed the TCL Theater to celebrate the first major Hollywood film that centers around a Filipino family.
This was a dream come true. And this movie, when I see it, it's like, you know, finally, like, our voices are being heard. And not just Filipinos, just everyone.
For Tia and I, it's been 40 years in coming. We're in a place where it's like we can own our own power. We can own our own voice. And we can put it out there. And if that empowers and passes the torch to other young writers, actors, filmmakers, whomever, that's why this film is more important. And I don't mean to aggrandize it too much, but that's why it makes it a cultural touchstone. Here we go, here we go.
And those were the latest headlines from North America. You can catch our stories online at news.abs-cbn.com/tscnews and the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel.